barely injured. Keep an eye on our dwarven friend here. Oh, we got it. That was cool. And no one died. Yay. Wow, okay. 98 gold, 45 gold. We got a rainbow obsidian necklace, a regular helmet, helm of Baldurin, get it back, and a magical mage robe. Mage robe of electrical resistance. Now we have two of those things. Could come in handy, but they're kinda, it's kind of hard to carry all this crap around. Oh, there's the stone to flesh scrolls that he gave us. You know, I think we're supposed to use that at... And so it was said it was an art gallery. But we didn't find the Helm of Baldurin there, so I don't know. But I remember those statues. We killed them. And I think there were six of them. Just says that now. A dire wolf unsummoned. There you go. You deserve that. Now, did we ever look in here? No, we never got to. Okay, another 63 gold. And in here? Should I be looking for traps? Not seeing anything. Ooh, magical splint mail. She's stuck now. Split mail plus one. Right. Well, that was cool.
Sure.
Serves him right. I mean, we killed him because he sent those things after us. And we wanted the helm anyway. So, that's our excuse. We should rest again.
Why me?
I hate to keep resting. Helm and cloak. Yeah, helm and cloak. And what was that guy's name? Felonius? Felonius something. I hate to rest again. But we can change our spells back. Because, oh wait, I do need to identify something, right? Or did I identify it all? I think I got it all, actually. Yeah, let's change our spells back. Add another magic missile. Why not? Armor, blindness. I don't like color spray. I don't like burning hands. Grease could work, but Lalak's minor drain is really weak at this point. Protection from evil only works on one person. Petrification is good. Shield. Shocking grasp, I don't like. Sets the wizard's armor class to 4. Armor class is already 2, so yeah, there's not really that many useful first level spells anymore. Sleep doesn't seem to be working. We have a chromatic orb. You know what? Here. Throw in charm person and 1 sleep, just in case. Mouse minute music meteors, we can get that back. Sweet. No one needs to level up, right? Just checking.
Alright. Alright.
Hate to keep resting, but we keep getting our butts kicked. Oh wait. Okay. Yep, still poisoned. I want to finish exploring this area. Took it so long.
Why me?
I keep dying.
No time to chit chat.
Oh. Oh, that's right. We were over there. Hey, where are you going? I don't want to leave my crew.
Such menial tasks. Such menial tasks.
Why me?
Bother and bother, never a calm spot. No time to chit-chat.
I don't think I'm gonna ruffle up anybody. Thank you. Hello there.
Sure.
Something you require?
Yes, goods.
Good job.
Let's see what's up here.
Good job.
Sleeping man and woman. Tiger carry shell necklace. I wonder if there's a very low chance of them like waking up, like 1 in 100 or something. History of the Moon Sea. Sounds very familiar. I'm pretty sure I have read it. Let me just make sure. The breathing sounds spooky for some reason. The snoring just sounds funny. History of the Moonseeker being one of the first things I found? Yes. Found it way back in episode 10. I'm done here.
Alright.
Thank you very much. It's another protector plus one. Armor class, saving throws plus one. We have some of those. That's the one we just looked at that people can't wear. Checking. He has one. Yeah, we can't use it. So I'll put it in here. Or here. And sell it. Hooray. Bye, lady.
All right.
Okay.
Sure.
Oh, there's people's up there. I wonder what this place is.
All right.
Why me?
Common air.
Sure.
Hey, get out of me way, you crummy loghead.
Mystery of the Vast.
I serve the Flaming Fist.
Why does that never work? Is it just because we went in the house? Sorry guys, I'm not dealing with that. Because usually the bookcases are fine.
Sure. Why me?
Hey, how are things going?
This way.
Valley of the Gods, I have that. Okay, we just have sleeping people here.
All right.
The flaming fish shouldn't come. I have all these books. Is it not locked? Algarth, I have that. So there's a way out here.
All right.
Okay.
Sure.
I've no interest in speaking to the likes of you.
Hey, how are things going?
Okay, neither of us can move.
Sure.
Okay. Move him back. Move her now.
Good job.
She can't move past him.
I've no interest in speaking to the likes of you.
Sure.
Yep.
All right.
It locked behind us.
Butt kicking for goodness!
Sure.
All right.
Oh, now there's more people coming.
A simple matter.
Hey, how are things going?
We're hopelessly stuck.
All right.
We can't walk past them?
Sure.
All right.
Oh my god.
Good job.
What?
I cannot deal with this.
By temper shield!
Okay.
Good job.
I don't... Sure.
Hey, how are things going?
Okay, now go out. Now the door's locked behind her.
Hey, how are things going?
We got a little extra experience that way. Now we can't get past those people, so we have to go back downstairs.
Go past us. All right. Why me?
No flaming fist, thank you. Not here. Color spray. I don't think I'll be needing that. We have them if we need them.
Why me?
We can go right in somehow. Phierkas.
Why me?
A stout hammer will fix most any bandit.
There's a fat man by the name of Algernon staying at Feldpost Inn in Beregost. He keeps a cloak with him in his room, and I need you to get your larcenous hands on it and bring it back to me. I assure you that your reward will be handsome. Try not to kill him. Just filch it off his person. Huh? Algernon's cloak. I'm talking to someone named Algernon. The dwarf Phierkas wants me to steal a cloak from an obese man named Algernon who I can find at Feldpost Inn in Beregost. Phierkas awaits his cloak in the northwest section of Baldur's Gate. Do you have Algernon's cloak with you? Nay, we do not.
All right.
Nobody in here? Just a sleeping woman. Another armor and a small shield. Nope. Not magical.
Why me?
All right.
Why me?
We're off.
All right.
Entar Silver Shield Estate. Awesome.
You're a handsome bunch, ain't ya?
Yeah, we've had that discussion.
A man shouldn't speak to his better unless spoken to first.
That's why I spoke to you first. We're gonna head here last. But this is Kagan's quest.
Hey, friend. Good to meet a fine sod such as yourself.
History of Shadowdale.
You said something?
13. Yeah, I said History of Shadowdale 13. Is that one of the ones we need? I said it's one of the ones we need.
Stranger.
Yeah, I need Shadowdale books. And we only need 9, 10, and 11. I kind of messed up a couple episodes ago. Picked up some Shadowdales I didn't need, actually. Can I get to this? I don't think we can get to that. Not with this guy here. Maybe he moves? I don't know.
Bother and bother, never a calm spot.
Life's been getting prickly on me, ours.
Away with you, or the guard will have you boiled in oil, or perhaps fricasseed in oil, with a lovely salmon, white wine sauce, and those little breadsticks are just so good. Yum.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Yes?
Yes.
Touch me not! You are unclean.
Salutations.
Hello. Nice to make the acquaintance of such a cultured personage.
How are you?
All right, let's go. I've been here, I just haven't gone in here.
Hello, pal.
Hi. Connolly Finn. Glad to make your acquaintance there, by golly. What might you be needing from old Connolly Finn? A tale of treachery amidst the nobles? Or a bit of back-alley skullduggery? I hear many things while tipping a bit of ale. Tell me what the common folk are talking about these days. The common folk? I don't know anyone that likes to be referred to in that way. I think most would tell you that the nobles are much less interesting than the common folk. We are free to go where we wish and speak to whomever we please. Nobles must worry about being seen with the wrong sort or being caught in the wrong place. Many a tale has been spilled about the hapless efforts or of noble fools trying to cover their exploits. Many a tale in this here bar, actually.
All right.
I can't ask him anything else. All right.
You're a handsome bunch, ain't ya?
But leave me be.
Yes?
You want some whiskey?
If you some complaints about the service, there's a wall out back to be glad to hear him. So would you like a drink? No, I'm good. These stairs are closed due to poor workmanship.
Life's been getting prickly on me,
I guess these are open though, but let's see what's back here. Absolutely nothing. Borinole Mann?
You're a long-tongued lout, ain't you?
You need something, stranger?
Hail and well met, young'un. Have you come to old Borinole for a tale or two of life in the realms? Or are you just strolling about meeting the folks of Baldur's Gate? Have you any interesting tales? Oh, I have tales. Whether they are interesting or not is a matter of debate, I suppose. I could share one with you, though it likely has no bearing on anything of importance. Nothing at all to be gained from the telling, save a moment of time well spent. By all means, go right ahead. Okay. I shall, then. It was the dawning of a new year, and Chester Blackboot and I were off to rally our friends and storm the gates of the old Fire and Wine ruins. Oh yeah, I've been there. Vella Stablehand was at the head. She was the eldest, you understand. We pretty much agreed that she should take point and absorb most of the initial damage when we attacked. Really? Of course, Vella had her father's axe, too, and that made her an imposing sight at the forefront. She was as tall as a pine and could deliver a backhand like you were so much silt on the breeze. I remember a time when she and Chester... This was Chester Allendale, no relation to the Black Boots, and a good thing, too. Them Black Boots had not patience for Vella and her shenanigans. While Chester and Vella were spelunking in the Old Caster, at least that's what the kids called it in those days. And her father comes up, and by golly, Vella up and belts Chester so hard he didn't hit the ground for a week. Vella's father sees this and laughs so hard he plumb forgets he's mad. He's like that, though. And the day he passes up a good joke would be the day he passes on entirely. I remember a time... I don't mean to be critical, but does this story have an end? Or a beginning, for that matter? Stories continue long after the exciting bits end, young'un. You'll miss a lot of life if you don't pay attention to anything outside of swinging the axe and smacking the head. Oh well, people had more patience in my time. Why, Buck Longbrow could stare at corn from seed to harvest, though he always was a bit shaky after the fall. Heh, leave me be. Well, you should have seen the other options. Those were the days, weren't they? All right.
Yep. All right, all right.
All right, regular daggers, throwing daggers. No. You're excused. Okay. 6 gold and a silver necklace. No one in any of these rooms. At least so far. The last thing I went after on the wall, or a wall, was trapped. There you go. Sweet. It's locked too. The hell is this? A dwarven artifact. What this artifact exactly does is unknown to you. The servants of Abathor want it. That's probably sufficient information. Is that a quest that we have? Okay. Potion of defense, those are good. Gold. Serpents of Abathor. Kagan's quest here. Entar Silver Shield's son was killed. Take the pin back to his family. I have the... It's called a fibula. And then here, too. We've agreed to help Eldoth with an extortion plan. He wants us to kidnap a young girl named Skye, who happens to be the daughter of the Grand Duke Entar Silver Shield. Eldeth has told us that Sky wants to escape home and would be a willing partner in the scheme. Once we have her, Eldeth will blackmail Entar. So we could, both of them, we go for that area. Serpents of Abathar. Tarash Black Helmet was extremely suspicious and aggressive. I had to kill him. Among his possessions, there was a letter pointing out that there would be an assassination north of the city, and I witnessed the ambush at the coastway and found a journal from a dwarf named Bashrik. I should bring it to the Temple of Helm in Baldur's Gate. A journal. Do we lose that? Yeesh. I don't know. I don't think we have a journal anymore, do we? Dinah here's journal. That's not it, though. I don't know. Alright, we're done up here.
Why me? Sure. Sure.
Tavern and Inn. So this place doesn't have a name, just Tavern and Inn. Oh, there's a little area. Undiscovered. Look at that.
What's your tale?
Alright. Every once in a while they have something new to say.
Why me?
Is this where we've already been? Oh no. It looks the same as the other place. Louise and Laerda? I thought this was this place with like the helm horrors and stuff.
I want my mommy.
Hi, I'm Louise. That's my twin sister, Laerda. We're nine. Hi, I'm Laerda. That's my twin sister, Louise. Mom and Dad don't believe us, but there's a boogeyman that comes and looks in our window every night. We're real glad we're twins, because if there was only one of us, then there'd be no one to hold on to when we get scared. Laerda and Louise. The young twins claim that a boogeyman watches them through their window every night. Now, I don't believe in boogeymen, but I've seen enough in my travels to believe that there's something out there, and I don't like the sound of it, really.